okay, how to solve this airport problem? One thing a lot of teams attempt to do, which is not correct, is the following. They just loop over every pair of vertices of the polygon, take the line segment in between, check whether that fits inside the polygon, and if so, consider it as a candidate. This fails on a couple of cases, but it gives a hint to the correct solution. And to see why that's the case, consider just an arbitrary line that's not going through any of the vertices. Can this be the largest landing strip? No, you can always, if it's not touching any vertices, then you can move this endpoint either to the left or the right, and then you get a larger landing strip. So you can move this all the way to this vertex, and you get a larger one. But the same holds for this point. This is not on any, still there's freedom, you can twiddle and move this around. So this will be, if you move it this way, you get a longer strip, namely this one. And this also shows how the solution should look like. The solution should always touch the bounding polygon in two points, in this case here and here. But these points are not necessarily the endpoints, such as in the sample case. So this gives now rise to the solution. Look for any two points of the polygon, look for the line in between them, see whether this piece is within the polygon, extend it to both sides, and then take the largest one. This is all easier said than done, for there are a lot of tricky cases. For example, you can have your landing strip through two of the points of the polygon, but the polygon can touch it, it can even go along the landing strip for a while. The landing strip can exit the polygon exactly on the bound on a vertex of the polygon. It can touch it for another while, then it can touch a vertex without exiting, etc., etc. And to solve this problem correctly, you have to tackle all these cases. And that's also where quite a few teams are going wrong. That's it.